Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can really easily drag and drop images into Canva into an organized collage. So I'm going to go up to Create Design and down to A4 Document. And we've got our plain A4 document up here. And the first thing we need to do is to go over to Frames. So I'm going to go to Elements. And if you can't see Frames down here, just go up to the search bar here and just type in Frames. So this section has been labeled Frames. Just go to See All, and here you'll get a wide selection of frames. Now, these frames, if you put them into your document, they act as a holder for your image, and your image will be cut to the size and shape of these frames. So today, I'm just going to use this plain square frame. Now, the one thing you do have to bear in mind with using square frames is that images, generally from cameras and phones, are not taken as square images. So there will be some cropping. Now, if you don't want that, that's fine. You can just go back over and you can use a rectangular frame if you want to. It's completely up to you. But for this demonstration, I'm going to show you how to use the square frames. So once you've inserted your frame, you can now go to the corners and obviously move this and resize it as much as you want. So I'm just going to drag this up to the top here and place it about here. And sometimes you just have to do this a little bit by trial and error. So I want to get three images across the top. So I think roughly around about that size will be fine. So to duplicate them, I just go up to this duplicate icon here. And as you can see, Canva's brilliant at aligning things. It will show you these pink dotted lines to show you that they're lined up. And once again, there we go. Now you can see that I haven't quite fitted them across the page. Now, if you do decide you want to make all of them smaller, you can select them all and then you can grab the corners and you can actually resize all of them at the same time. It takes out a little bit of the guesswork. Once you've selected them all, you can go up to Position. And then you can go to this icon here. Now this icon makes sure that they're equally spaced out. There's an equal gap between each one. But in order to center them all, if I click center now, they will center everything to the center. If I go back, Command or Control Z, what I actually need to do first is to group them, then go to center, because now they're one group. Now let's misalign that one and click center. And you can see they're all perfectly centered. Now that they're grouped, I can simply duplicate that group, bring that down, continue to do that. I'm going to have four rows. There we go. Now you can have them all equally spaced like this. It's done a great job of aligning these, but if you're not sure that they're all aligned, you can select them all. You can see they're all aligned to the side, but if they're not, you can go back over to the positions and then you can align to left, align to center. Once you've done that, you can group everything together and then you can go over and click middle and it will align all of them to the center of your page. Now to put your images in, you have to ungroup everything. And now when you click on an individual frame, you can see just the individual one is selected. Now, if you want to insert your images, go back over to Elements and click. You can use all the photographs that Canva has to offer if it's not a pro version. So if you go to Photos and click See All, you can see that you've got a wide variety of images to choose from. And if you can't find what you need, then just go up to the search bar here and click what you need. So let's just say I wanted coffee, and then it will bring up all your choices of images for coffee. Now you can see some of these have got a crown on. Those are for the pro version of Canva. But if it doesn't have anything on the image, then you can use it for free. If you want to use your own images, go to Upload. And I've only got a few uploads here. But if you want to upload your own image, just simply go up to Upload Files. Then you can select an image of your choice. Let's say I select this one and click Upload. And there you can see that image has been uploaded. Then all you need to do is click and drag that image over. You can drag it over any of these frames. You can see the border changes and the photograph goes into that box. So let's pop it in here. Now you can see it's cropped my image. If I double click, You can see that now I can move my image. I obviously can't move the width because it's at its full width, but I can move the photograph up and down and then just click on the outside here and it will deselect the image. Now, if you don't like the image, so obviously if I try to move this box, it moves the whole image. What you have to do is click on these three dots here and you need to go down to detach image. And that will detach the image and then you can grab it again and go again, or you can just simply delete it. So let's just detach that image and then we can click the delete button. So now if I go over to photos, let's go back over to elements. Let's type in dogs, here we go. And then now we can simply click and drag those images to where we want them. Perfect. So once you're finished, you can export this by going up to Share. Then you can go to Download and then go up to File Type and click on the drop down. And here you can select from a number of different file options. Once you've chosen your file, just simply click Download and then Canva will just download your image. So if I now go to my Downloads, and then you can see my design at the top. If I just double click on it to open it, you can see now I have that file as a JPEG. And I can use that and insert it into a website, into a document, into a PowerPoint presentation, or just simply print it out. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.